This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. So I forgot to share the dreams that my daughter had. She asked last night, she came into my room and she was saying she was scared or something, so she wanted to sleep in my room. And usually I don't play that, and she sleep in her own room. But yesterday I gave in and I allowed her to sleep in my room. And like at some point last night, I was rolling over and I woke up. I could hear her saying something about the Holy Spirit and fire, but she was sleeping. So in her sleep, she was talking about the Holy Spirit and fire. And so she was saying like some other stuff, but when she woke up that morning, by the time she woke up, I was already reading and writing. And she woke up and she said, "I had a bad dream." And I was like, "You did?" And she was like, "Yeah." And I said, "What happened?" And then she remembered, "Oh, I had a good dream." Said, "You had a good dream too?" I said, "Well, tell me." I said, "Tell me what happened." She said, "I'll tell you about the good one first." And she said, "I was at so-and-so's house and they gave me all their jewelry. I was at so-and-so's house and they gave me all their jewelry." And who she was saying was somebody who kind of, they've been a thorn in my side. They've been a thorn in my side, okay? And so it remind me of Exodus 12, 35 and 36, where the Israelites, Pharaoh was putting them out of Egypt, and they got silver and gold from the Egyptians. It says they got silver and gold, all that they required, or something like that. And so what I believe that the Holy Spirit is conveying is that whatever has had you in bondage, whatever has had you, has been a thorn in your side, it's paying off. It may be financial, I don't know, but whatever God allowed you to go through it or what have you, you're receiving recompense now. You're receiving payment for it, whether it's going to be tenfold, a hundredfold, whatever. It reinforces the message that he gave yesterday that, things have to be assessed to see how much repayment is owed. So whatever has had you in bondage or whatever, you are receiving repayment. We are receiving repayment for it, okay? We're being recompensed, okay? It's paying off, all right? The other dream she had, she said that she was in the water and there were sharks in the water, and she said the shark bit her foot off. And I was like, now remember, she's four. I said, "The shark bit your foot off?" She said, "Well, my toe." I said, "He bit your whole toe off?" Because I remember I was reading somewhere it said, like, if you lose one of your toes, I don't know if it was I thought it said the pinky toe, that you won't be able to walk. So when she telling me the story, I'm like, "Dad, why would, you know?" So I said, "He bit your whole toe off?" And she said, "No, I was still able to walk." So I believe it's just confirmation that God is saying, number one, whatever has had you in bondage is paying off now. He's giving recompense for it. And number two is whatever damage that was done in the process, you still gonna be able to walk. You still gonna be able to move forth in the things that he's telling you to do. Just like Jacob, when Jacob wrestled with the angel of the Lord, he had a limp, but he was still able to receive his inheritance. He was still able to go forth. So, that's that. Be encouraged in Jesus' name.